Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to Conversations with the Empress. I am the Empress. And it's here. It's Freaky Friday. And I feel like I'm looking super sexy and freaky today. I mean, what y'all think? I gotta be careful I don't have no nip slips or nothing like that on this show. But so today, the topic for the show today is hilarious because just the way I came up with it. So, true story. I'm at work today and I get a text from a friend who I haven't spoken to in a while, haven't seen in a while, my girlfriend. And she hits me randomly and is like, "What's a glory hole?" And for those of y'all who don't know what a glory hole is, it's basically a room with a whole bunch of holes in the wall and guys come in and put their penises in the hole and a random woman will just suck it and they don't see each other. So it's called a glory hole. It's called a glory hole. Sorry for the outdoor noise. Lots of motorcycle people around here. So I started laughing and I'm like, this is so funny. I haven't heard from her. And she's asking me about a glory hole. So then I go and I ask my coworkers, three of my coworkers, if they knew what a glory hole was and they didn't know. So I'm like, oh, so I need to do the show on different types of parties and stuff. So today I'm going to talk about the different types of alternative lifestyle parties. First of all, a glory hole, which also could also be not just oral sex happening in the glory hole. It could be like openings where you could just lay down and your lady bits is open and somebody that you don't even know will come and just give you what you need. You never see the person. It's just all about feeling and not seeing. Not really my type of thing, but some people are into that. For people who want to be anonymous or, you know, people that don't really want to have that deeper interaction with somebody, glory hole is great. It's all about getting your rocks off and then going home to whatever you're going home to. So that's a glory hole. Another type of party is a gangbang party. A gangbang party is normally when it's one female and it's advertised that way. It's one female and a whole plethora of different guys will come throughout the night and either have sex with her all at the same time or run trains on her or one by one. And normally she's the only girl at the party and they'll charge you more as an extra girl coming because you're taken away from her shine for being the slut for the night. Also not my thing. More power to you if that's your thing though. I'm not hating. It's just not my thing. You know, some people go to these parties just to let go and just be their inner slut that they never get to be. So I don't hate on anybody for what they like to do. The other party is a simple swing party. Swinging is basically having sex with different people in a social event or whatever, but a lot of people go to swing parties and don't have sex at all. A lot of voyeurism happens at swing parties. Even though I prefer for people to play, there's always people that come to parties that will just watch and be voyeurs or whatever. The parties that I have gone to have mostly been in houses or hotels. The last party I went to was at a house, but it was like a huge house. They had the whole basement laid out with mattresses, like 8 beds, and there's tables around. They give you refreshments and you mingle before you go to play. So it's like, it's more of a social thing that leads to sex as opposed to like a glory hole and a gangbang where you just know what's going on. Like, that's what's going on. I like swing parties, not necessarily because I like to have sex, but I have a huge ego. So I just love to get really dressed up, put on my best lingerie, my heels. I mean, y'all already know I like the lingerie and the heels. And I like to just walk around and get attention. I mean, every once in a while, I might come across somebody that I want to be intimate with. But just like in the real world, I got to be feeling some type of vibe from you or whatever. And a lot of guys make the mistake of thinking that because they're going to a swing party that they're guaranteed to get some booty. And that's not the case. You still have to talk to a woman. She still has to feel your vibe and decide if she wants to have sex with you or not. So that's a misconception that a lot of guys who haven't been to parties have, is that it's guaranteed pussy. It's not. I like the social aspect of swinging. I've also been to swing clubs, which was dope. La Trapeze in New York used to be dope, but it closed down, but they had different rooms. They had public rooms, they had private rooms, they had one huge room that the whole floor was a mattress and everybody just laid out, had sex around everybody. Like, they had a stripper pole. That spot was lit. Then, like, you know, with the swinging thing, I feel like you have, like, if you're swinging by yourself, cool, you don't have any rules. But if you go with someone, like a boyfriend or, you know, somebody that you're going there with, you guys really should have rules before you go. Because I've definitely seen people get upset at parties about their person, you know, doing whatever with somebody else or whatever. But you really need to talk about y'all rules before y'all go, if y'all plan on playing. That way there's no confusion, no boundaries are crossed, and there's no problems or whatever. Lots of people don't do that, and they just go to a party with their partner, and then it's like World War III because they didn't know what to expect, how they was going to handle it, what they was going to do. They didn't even have a conversation about it. So it's always important to discuss things and have consent and all. You know, I always talk about consent and all that. The last type of party I'm going to talk about is like a BDSM party. Now, I have been to BDSM parties. I have been to BDSM clubs, and I can't even say what I prefer. There's pros and cons to both. Well, I'll tell you what I like about both. What I like about going to the BDSM club is that you can see so many things that you were not going to see or experience, like, unless you're with a BDSM master. They do fire play. They do suspensions. They do caging. They do bondage. They do candle play. Night play. There's this spot in New York called Paddles. Y'all probably heard me talk about it before. But they have, like, private, like, well, not private, but, like, secret rooms. And I remember I went this one night, and they had opened up this secret room, which was, like, all medieval stuff in there. Like, so they had the thing where you lay on the thing, and it stretches you. They had the thing where they put you on the wheel and spin you around and whip you while they spin you. Like, that, that shit was crazy. I didn't even get to play in that room that night because they opened it, like, right when I was leaving. Hopefully one day I'll get to go back in there and play, because I've been thinking about getting stretched out on that table since I seen it. I definitely have been thinking about getting stretched out on that table and having somebody do something strange to me since I seen that table. But BDSM clubs are something for your eyes. Like, you are going to see stuff that you never saw before. And if you're a voyeur, it is like candy for your eyes. So, I remember the first time I went to a BDSM club, I was actually in a dynamic, and I had two sister submissives and our dominant, and we all went on leash and collar, and like the room spread for us when we went in, and it was just quite a night. We took over a room and did a whole scene, and the crowd was just watching and just so impressed with everything, and it was just dope. Like, I had the best time ever. I went back several times after that and did scenes in front of people and stuff like that, flogging scenes, impact play scenes. I love going to the club. Love playing at the club, love going to the club. Now, I've also been to BDSM parties, like, in houses. Now, the good thing about BDSM parties in houses is that they're normally friendly for swingers and BDSM people. So if you are a swinger and you're curious about BDSM, you could always go to a BDSM party and get your taste of both. You want to swing a little bit, you could swing. If you find somebody there you want to play and experiment with BDSM, you could do that. I remember I had a girlfriend, her and her man would throw the best parties. They would rent out huge houses, Airbnbs or whatever, and it would just be so many people. They would do icebreakers and games. There'd be refreshments. They had smoking area to smoke outside. Lots of BDSM play going on all around, and also lots of sex going on in other rooms and stuff like that. So, you know, different strokes for different folks. But you know me. You know I'm a fan of the BDSM, because for me, I've had so much sex in my life that, like, sex is kind of like the icing on the cake. If somebody know how to make me go through physical changes and make me come without having sex with me, that's like so big to me. Then like after I do a BDSM scene, that's probably when I want to have sex. I kind of did the BDSM. I got into BDSM before I got into swinging, so I kind of did it backwards. But for me, in order for me to swing, like, I have to be super horny because it's just sex. You know what I mean? BDSM is more fulfilling for me because it fulfills more parts of who I am. You know, my masochist side, my submissive side, you know, and then I get to have sex too. So I am a fan of BDSM. But all this started because my girls at work didn't know what a glory hole was. So you definitely could find all these types of parties and stuff. There's websites you go. There's always FetLife, www.fetlife.com. The biggest swing site that I know is www.sls.com if you're curious about anything. And also, if you're curious about anything, you know you can always holler at your girl. You know, I'm going to give you the truth. I'm going to give you the real, raw deal truth about whatever you ask. And you know, I might be sliding out to a party. You might want to come. Who knows? You know, say you know the Empress, you know. But anyway, I hope this was enlightening for you guys. I hope that it piqued your curiosity for maybe some activities you might want to do in the future. And I hope you like my lingerie. I liked it. Just a little wiggle on my way out. But if you like this show, you like me, you like what I had to say, please go like, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel, Conversations with the Empress. I had to be real careful tonight with this outfit because I ain't trying to get my YouTube channel shut down. Shut down. But anyway, until we meet again, thank you for watching. Smooches.